So Jennifer Beals is hooking up with us here. Hold on. Let me put it. Let me get it.
Hi, we're ready.
We are ready to go.
What year did it come out?
I don't remember. No. It's a long time ago.
Well, you saw it in the movie theaters.
I did.
And you were
I did.
But taken
was,
by it.
That was like a lifetime ago.
Flash Dance.
You
know? Let's see when it was out.
83.
Okay, so 83. I was one. That's why I missed it.
Yeah.
But it's something I will go back and watch, I guess.
Jennifer, they're hooking us up with her. Jennifer stars in the television show NBC's Taken.
And
I just,
so pretty.
I just started watching it, and it's good. It's kind of like a, I want to say, a modern-day kick-ass James Bond kind of thing. And she's like Q. She's the head of the agency, you know? Is that what Q's job is in Bond?
Well, you think?
But I think, and she's coming on with us because I think in the next couple episodes of Taken on NBC, she's out in the field. And it gets a little hairy, so she's getting to shoot all the action scenes, which is pretty cool. Yeah, that's when she broke on the scene, was with Flashdance. She was in The Bride, where she played the Bride of Frankenstein. She was in The L Word, a great series on Showtime. So they're hooking us up with her. Jennifer, you're not there. Hello?
Okay. Yes, I'm right here.
Oh, you've been sitting here the whole time. Wow, I'm sorry. See, Jennifer,
on a little fly on the wall there.
Yeah. Oh, God, I didn't say anything bad. No, because what happens usually is I hear a noise. You know, in my headphones, I hear an ee, and then I know you're on the line. So my apologies to you. So there you go. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm very well. Thanks for coming on with us. We're out here in New England. And so I just started watching Taken. And like I said, you obviously heard, it's a cool show. And it's weird when you take a movie. I've always kind of, as a fan, you know, you take a movie and you make a television show out of it. You never know what's going to work, especially with what became, I think, a bit of a phenomenon, the original movie Taken with Liam Neeson. But this is really a very good adaptation of that movie. I think it works really well.
Thanks. Yeah, it's kind of like a telling of the origin story, like the modern day origin storytelling.
Yeah, and you're kind of you're the head of the agency, and by the way, I'll just get this out of the way. Absolutely phenomenally, stunningly beautiful. So there you go. I said it. And
thank you. It's a lot of lighting, a lot of hair and makeup.
Okay, whatever. It is
they
good.
They are they're so in love. They've been talking about you all week.
Well, but in the next couple episodes, right, you kind of switch roles. You kind of are the one that's out in the field. And I don't know if previously in the previous season you ever did that. That's my first question.
No, she doesn't really go out in the field. She's really, you know, that's Brian's
right.
expertise.
So
pretty much for the series. And but I think that she's got a few loose ends in her path that she's got to tie up. And the episode definitely explains why she maybe doesn't have the best taste in men.
Right. Okay. And
and it explains a lot of later behavior, apparently.
Okay.
So,
Jennifer, please.
Let's see. I haven't seen it yet, so all I know is the script. I don't know how it's been edited, but there's a lot of action.
And that's got to be cool, because that was my leading. I was leading to the point where, wow, look, you get to be the action hero, you know, for a couple of episodes. What was that like for you? Did you enjoy it?
It's fun. Yeah, it's definitely fun. I mean, I love both. Like, as long as there's great writing, it's fun,
mm-hmm.
right? So,
mm-hmm.
so this episode was really interesting to explore, you know, the writer's idea of what her past was.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we got to get into some different areas that you don't normally see Christina get into.
Yep. Jennifer Beals, who stars in Taken, Friday nights, 9 o'clock on NBC. Go ahead, Roka.
Now, Jennifer, this is an odd question, but I'm going to throw it at you. Are you willing to,
okay.
are you willing to share your co-host? It's not your co-host, but the gentleman you act with, Clive, because I also know he's part of the TV show Vikings. We haven't seen him for a while, but they teased that he would be coming back.
Oh, that would be amazing.
So I didn't know, because I know that he left the show to go do this show with you.
Okay, all right.
And
so are you asking her a question about Vikings or Taken?
Because he is
for intel. Are you asking the woman who plays a spy herself?
If you might have some info, is there a good chance he's coming back to Vikings? Yes.
I don't know if a question
that's like side information. I'm sorry, that's
side
information. And if Clive hasn't told you, then you know
I have some listeners wanted to ask a couple of questions. They wanted to ask if let me see here ask about the movie Four Rooms. You're an integral part of that movie that tied everything together. It's one of her favorite movies, and she just wanted me to say that it was a Kristen who loved you in the Four Rooms, so she wanted me to tell you that.
Okay. I thought it was. That was a really fun project.
I thought it was a question. I have to. Kelly Brown has a question for you. Jennifer Beals on the phone.
Jennifer, we know you can dance, but I'm reading your bio here: kung fu, sand shoe, kickboxing, and you're a triathlete.
The kung fu, all that is completely made up. I don't know where that came from or which site you're on, but that's totally untrue.
It says here you're a brain surgeon.
In fact, I often laugh with Clive that I call his martial art Muay Thai.
Hey, how, you know,
not a martial artist, only in my fantasy
I guess Wikipedia is getting a little carried away.
Can I ask, did you used to work at Baskin-Robbins as a teenager?
I did work in Baskin-Robbins, and I have done triathlon. So those two things are true.
It's amazing we've never met, given that I'm a large guy that likes ice cream. That's crazy.
Of what you can find in somebody's, like, you Google their name, and it could put some information out there that you're like,
is that weird, Jennifer, right? Because, I mean, there are things, even on any level, the internet is a place of, all the good it could be used for, and sometimes it gets used for other things. But what's the weirdest thing? Maybe not kung fu, that somebody said, oh, you did this, and you're like, I don't know what you're talking about.
I think it's the kung fu, actually. Hey, I've heard that one. That's a new one.
You're a winner. I love that. when you find I have to say that I watched The L Word, which I thought was great. What a great series. And I know that you won awards for that and stuff. Is Flashdance still the thing? You know, it's weird. Back in 1983, you're pretty much a kid, right? A young woman. And this this movie becomes this phenomenon, right? Were you ready for that when that happened?
I don't think anybody can be ready for that.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think you can ever be ready for it. You navigate it to the best of your ability. And fortunately, I was in college and doing something that I knew how to do, which was studying and writing papers and taking tests and things. So it helped ground me, for sure.
Did they ever approach you about doing a flash dance, too? Because it seemed like the 80s was always about a part two, part three, part four.
Yeah, there was talk about that.
I always think about that, and you know, whenever it is, whether you're a musician and you work your whole life to put out that first album, right? Or you're an actress or an actor and you work your whole life to get to a certain point where you can get in a movie that gets seen. And then all of a sudden, all of that work, that dream becomes a almost an overnight reality. I've always thought, like you said, there is no way to prepare you for that white-hot spotlight, right?
Right, I agree with that.
And I think the same of all these people who are like, I'm going to put my family on a reality TV show. I'm like, I would never do that because you are not ready for the kind of attention that you get. I'm always amazed that people will do that.
And also, for me, it wasn't really about attention and it wasn't about trying to be famous. It was just this thing that I like to do.
Right.
Acting. And then it just became more and more and more.
Yeah.
And found myself in the spotlight. It wasn't as if I searched out the spotlight so that I could stand there.
I got you.
Attention.
I got you. I know what you mean. I didn't mean to intimate.
And I differentiate because there are people who really love that and they crave that. And so maybe for them that experience is different.
Yeah.
And much more pleasurable.
Yeah.
But for me, it was tricky. You know, it was really tricky to walk down the street and have people know who I was, and I didn't know who they were, and they had information about me, and I didn't know anything about them. That was a very odd position for me to be in, whereas for somebody else who, you know, loves attention, that might be something that they really, really enjoyed.
Yeah, I'm all set, thanks. I get it. I totally get it. The show is called Taken. It's on tomorrow night at 9 o'clock, and it's good. And I love you. Very smart character. Like I believe you are very smart, obviously, and it's great to get a chance to talk to you. We've never had you on the show, and it's nice to finally meet you through the phone. So thanks for coming on with us.
Thank you for having me on the show.
Keep up the kung fu, Jennifer.
next time we talk, I'm going to be a black belt.
There it is. You heard it here first. Take care, Jennifer. Thanks very much. Appreciate it.